Welcome back to the Weekly Warrior. I'm Noah Armstrong.
And I'm Angel Edwards.
Hey Angel, what's red and bad for your teeth?
What?
A brick.
And with that, on to news.
Hi, I'm George.
And I'm Braden, and this is news.
This weekend, the speech and debate team is hosting the conference tournament against Maryville, Lafayette, Benton, and Savannah.
Wow, well good luck this weekend, guys. In other news outside the Ville, a 19-year-old Georgia woman has fought her way onto the ballot and, if elected, could become one of the youngest elected officials in the United States. Mary Pat Hector, a sophomore at Atlanta Spelman College, is seeking a city council seat in the newly incorporated city of Stonecrest, a suburb east of Atlanta that is home to 50,000 residents.
Wow, that's very impressive at such a young age, too.
Yeah, I'm going to reevaluate my life now.
Well, while you do that, let's move on to the court-warming candidates. For Kings, we have Luke Vollenweider, Alexander Drake, Kate Torkelson, Sam Aviles, and Bradley Covey. For our Queen candidates, we have Kaylin New, Josie Grandinet, Lexi Duncan, Hannah Termer-Susan, and Eliza Baber.
Wow, congratulations to all of our candidates for being nominated, and good luck. That's all for us. Let's move on to specials.
Hey guys, it's Special. I'm Blake, and I'm here with Chance, and we're going to talk to him about the SWAT spaghetti dinner. So what are the details on this dinner?
Well, we have a SWAT spaghetti dinner annually, and we kind of help for the fundraising for robotics. Since it is a, it takes a lot of money to run a robotics team. But yeah, we're having a robotics spaghetti dinner on Thursday, February 23rd, and it will be from 5:30 to 7:30 p.m.
So the 23rd, all that kind of stuff.
Yeah.
What time is it going to be at?
5:30 to 7:30. Yeah.
All right. Is there anything else that you want us to know about it?
Well, adults will be $7. Children will be under 10 will be $3. And we will have the robots on display. We'll have the game field kind of set up, you know, ready. We might do FTC, which is the little robots. But yeah, we'll definitely have the FRC finished robot on display.
All right, sounds like a plan. Thanks for that. And now back to the anchors.
Wow, I can't wait for that spaghetti dinner.
Sounds like it'll be fun. And all the proceeds go to SWAT Robotics team, so make sure you show up and chow down.
I wonder if it'll be warm for that dinner.
Well, let's go to weather and find out.
Hey, it's Lauren.
And I'm Dayton. Welcome back to weather.
This week has been warm, and the great weather is going to continue for the rest of the week.
Saturday and Sunday will be literally wonderful, with temperatures between 65 and 69 degrees, so get out your swim trunks and head to the lake. But actually don't, because the lake is still very cold and you could freeze to death.
Next week is going to start cooling down. Monday, there will be a high of 65 degrees and a low of 50 degrees.
It will continue to cool off through the rest of the week. On Tuesday, the high will be 60 degrees and the low will be 42 degrees.
Wednesday and Thursday will be around 53 degrees.
And we will end the week on Friday with a high of 53 degrees and a low of 36 degrees.
And for the tip of the week, turn off your alarm quickly and efficiently by smashing it with a brick. It will not bug you ever again. I do the same thing, except my alarm clock is my phone.
Also, save the whales because whales are endangered. That's all for us this week.
Now on to you, sports.
Hi, I'm Shannon.
And I'm George. This week at sports, the girls won their game Monday, and the boys had senior night on Tuesday during their game against LeBlanc. Unfortunately, they lost.
Also, Jake Boyd and Austin Pearl got first at district, so they will be going along with many more of their teammates to state today.
The girls have a game today against Lafayette, and the boys have a game tomorrow, also against Lafayette, so go out and cheer them on.
Last weekend, Lakeside received their 12th first place Jazz competition trophy. And congratulations to all the debate participants for performing well last weekend, but especially to Serena Maxfield, Robbie Schwind, and Haley Simpson for receiving first.
Congratulations, everyone. Well, that's all for sports this week. Now back to the anchors. George!
I'm so ready for that 60-degree weather.
Sounds like it'll be the bee's knees.
Speaking of bees, let's go to Odd.
Hey guys, Chase back with Odd Squad, and this week we are unwrapping candy with mittens, even though you can't smash, use the teeth or anything.
Trying to hold back this feeling for so long.
It's easy.
And if you feel like I feel,
Let's get it on.
Let's get it on.
Since we got to be I love you. There's nothing wrong with me loving you.
Oh my God, this is so hard.
And giving yourself to me can never be wrong.
Bam. Wow, that sure was odd.
Yeah, it reminds me of my Valentine.
Oh, why is that?
Looks like we're out of time for this week. See you guys next week.